You can start if you want now.
Hold on, let me open up the Twitch.
Okay. Also, Cody, if you do want to talk in, like, the stream chat, then I can read it. Oh, God. Hi, Stream Elements.
Jesus! I gotta log in on my...
When did I say yippee? Damn.
God damn it.
Hey, I forgot Cat had a PNG. Isn't it so cute?
781...
I also have a UPNG. Where is it?
280.
There he is! It's not gonna work because you're muted, but look it, it's you.
There we go.
Bunny.
I love how Cody just, like, went on my account and subscribed to Cinnabum. Nothing else.
You subscribed to Cinnabum?
On my account.
Thank you for following. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to... Hello, Shadow and Light!
Shadow and Light! Oh my god, it's you!
We've missed you. Don't mind me slowly scooting myself over. By the way, Cody, we gotta continue DDLC sometime. I don't have much time, I hate schedules. I should make an extra PNG of a sleeping bunny when- Aw, oh, yeah! That'd be so cute! You totally should. It's okay. Again, if, like, you can't join because you have to go to bed or you're busy, that's totally fine. You can always join another time. You gonna press the A button?
I'm eating.
My bad. So I honestly know nothing about this game. So do what Senna did and just yell. I mean, yes, literally. Although it is almost 10 o'clock, I don't think I should be yelling. I should screen record that. Yeah, I should have a button that
okay.
plays that
I'm anytime ready.
Anybody ever apologizes. Okay. Ooh. Shit. Hang on. Wait, pause. Oh yeah. I'm gonna And also I have to edit the crop a little bit. Hang on, I'm screen recording our Discord call, so this is gonna be kinda weird. So give me a sec for a sec. Don't worry about it. Be nice to me.
Hey, you wanna French this?
Oh, fuck yeah, you know I do. Okay, don't get out of this, because I need this real quick. Okay, that is not right. I know, it's heartbreaking. Hello, welcome back. I'm currently trying to get everything to fit, so give me a sec. Cat, I told you not to get out of it.
I'm sorry, Jesus. Hello, pineapple.
I think that's right.
Do you perhaps like pork soda?
Damn. Oh God.
I'm not fighting.
We would never fight. We're married.
If Icy tells me to do something, then I listen, and I do it.
See, this is why you're my favorite. Oh god.
Oh, Pineapple doesn't get it.
I'm sorry. Okay, I was supposed to do this all before,
so upset.
But everything seemed normal before because it was a black screen, so hang on. Okay, now it's normal. Oop, don't look at my
screen. Alright,
don't look
we ready?
At my Discord shit. Yeah, I'm ready. Wait, what'd I say? What'd you say to Pineapple? I don't remember. What did you say?
I asked Pineapple if Pineapple liked Park Soda. They didn't get it. I'm really upset.
Vivid Colt!
Vivid Colt!
Wow. Oh lordy. Your
nobody gets it.
Your obsession.
And since you guys don't get it, this is why no one could. Vivid Colt, do you like pork soda?
Do you guys like Dixon cider?
I asked a question.
God damn. I don't get it now.
See, this is why I can't have nice things in life. I can't even find anyone who likes pork soda.
Okay.
As much as I do.
No, they're a pretty popular band. I'm pretty sure they do know it. They just don't understand who the fuck asks that? They're thinking about it literally.
I asked that.
Yeah, because you're a freak. It's Kat is obsessed with glass animals. That's what she's asking. You guys like the song. God damn.
I asked it because one of the lines is pineapples are in my head. That's why I asked Pineapple.
Oh. Yeah. You're a freak. You've never heard of it? Damn. They're a pretty popular band right now. I think.
Their song Heat Waves was like number one. On the Billboard's hottest singles, I think it was, or something.
Damn.
Like in what, 2021, 2022?
That's who made that?
Yeah.
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 I like their, the one that used to be an animation meme. Pork Soda was one of those. But there was another one, and I really liked
it. Was it The Other Side of Paradise?
Yeah. I really like that song.
Yeah. See, I didn't even know that pork soda was even like liked or like a meme until Cody was like, hey, yeah, your favorite song is actually like ruined for me because it was an animation meme. And I was like, this really upsets me.
That's all I can think
But it makes sense because it's such a good song.
Yeah, I just see people like animating their stupid little personas, like, bumping their heads.
Well, you know what? Pork soda means so much to me in ways that you guys would never understand. And I don't need to get into the logistics of that, because that's just how it is.
Mm-hmm.
I love pork soda, and pork soda loves me.
Mm-hmm. I believe it. I haven't heard, so I wouldn't know. It's a good song. I'd say.
Loser.
Wow.
I mean.
Wow.
I don't know who said that.
Is it an animation? Sorry, Kat. Kat gets kind of aggressive when it comes to her favorite bands, okay? I thought Kat loved me. Yeah, but know your place. Not as much as she loves glass animals.
I don't anymore because you don't like pork soda. Sorry.
It's not that they don't like it. They don't know it.
Exactly.
Stop baby raging right now or I'm gonna throw you at the wall.
Yeah, if you don't like pork soda, then you don't like me.
Are we ever gonna start Ace Attorney? Are you gonna continue to fight people in my chat?
I'm going to fight everyone I need to give pork soda justice.
I was gonna listen to it, but maybe I won't. Ooh.
Well, you know what? That's your fucking loss. If you don't want to listen to it, then, you know, I can never love you.
I literally never stop baby raging. This is like
yeah, see, hell. Ghostface gets it. Ghostface
that's,
gets it.
That's Archie.
I love you, Ghostface.
That's Archie.
I love you, Archie.
Pork sods. Hey, be nice.
Pork sods.
Pork so what? Ooh.
You better give that a 1.5 higher rating.
Cat is obsessed.
I love you too, Archie. No, I'm obsessed with pork soda. I don't know what glass animals is, and I've never heard of them.
Stop gaslighting people. Stop lying to people. I'm tired of it. Stop it. Stop doing that. Stop. This is an intervention. Animals made of glass. Duh. Okay. Maybe I need you dead. I never thought about that.
Okay, we're playing.
Oh, okay.
Ooh.
Okay, maybe start with the first one. Has anybody here played this game or seen this game? Because I haven't. I don't know anything about it other than I liked a song that had it. The music video was this game.
Agnes, oh my fucking god.
Nope. I fucking love it.
You guys never understand how much Agnes means to me.
Oh god, what did you do? What did you get her started on?
You guys don't understand.
Goodnight.
That song is what Taxi Cab by 21 Pilots is to me.
Bye-bye! Say bye-bye to Shadow
and Light. No one's gonna get it.
Cat, shh.
Nobody will understand it the way I do.
Cat, say goodbye to Shadow and Light.
I'm the number... Bye! Bye, Shadow and Light!
Can't murder people, so I'll never play it. What the fuck is wrong with you, man? Every day, I wonder. Miles Edgeworth? Is that the bitchy boy? The bitchy boy? Because you would. Kat said that I'm gonna voice him and she's gonna voice the main guy so we can fight. I also like the pretty girl. I don't know anything about her, but she's a pretty girl. I just like to kill things, and that's why I'm worried about
you.
No.
You could kill me.
No, you can't.
Nope. Bite slip.
Nope. Nope. Nuh-uh.
Winks aggressively.
Please, no.
Alright, let's play. I just got an achievement.
Whoa. What is that?
Oh god, who's gasping? Hey, why did it skip?
Hey, why did it skip? Hey!
Hey!
Hey, what's happening?
Damn it, why me? I can't get caught. Not like this! I gotta find someone to pin this on. Someone like him. Oh my god. What the fuck is happening? I'll make it look like he did it.
Do you have auto on?
There was an auto on in the menu.
Okay, apparently that was just the intro. So it's just telling us who did it already?
Boy, am I nervous.
Who's Mia? Is that the pretty
Mia?
Girl?
You want to be the pretty girl? You should be the pretty girl.
I love pretty girls. Right. Ooh, pretty girl.
Ooh, titties.
No, it's not.
Oh, hi, Chief.
Ah, oh, she's so pretty. Stop, I'm actually in love with her. I'm glad I made it on time. Well, I have to say, Phoenix, I'm impressed. Not everyone takes on a murder trial right off the bat. It says a lot about you and your client as well. Okay, I think I need to sleep. Good night. Good night, Cody.
Thanks. Good night, Cody. Actually, it's because I owe him a favor.
A favor? You mean you knew the defendant before this case?
Yeah. Actually, I kind of owe my current job to him. He's one of the reasons I became an attorney.
Well, that's news to me.
I want to help him out in any way I can. Just really want to help him. I owe him that much. It's over! My life! Everything! It's all over!
Is that your client screaming over there?
Yeah, it's him. Do you want to be the client?
Sure.
I already voice him, but... Okay.
Death! Despair! Oh! The client is baby raging. I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna die! It sounds like he wants to die.
Yeah.
Oh, what the
fuck? Oh my god!
Like that?
Your butts!
Ew, he's so ugly!
Hey, butts!
Hey, butts. Nick!
Butts. Hey there, Larry.
What? Dude, I'm so guilty! Tell them I'm guilty! Give me the death sentence! I ain't afraid to die!
What's wrong, Larry?
Oh, it's all over. I'm finished. Finished! I can't live in a world without her. I can't. Who took her away from me, Nick? Who did this? Oh, Nick, you gotta tell me. Who took my baby away?
The person responsible for your girlfriend's death? The newspapers say it was you.
Well, it wasn't. We already know who it was.
My name is Phoenix Wright. Here's a story. My first case is a fairly simple one. A young woman was killed in her apartment. The guy they arrested was the unlucky sap dating her. Larry Butts. My best friend since grade school. Our school had a saying, when something smells, it's usually the butts.
A what?
In the 23 years I've known him, it's usually been true. He has a knack for getting himself in trouble. One thing I can say, though, it's usually not his fault. He just has terrible luck. But I know better than anyone. He's a good guy at heart. That I owe him one. Which is why I took the case, to clear his name. And that's just what I'm going to do.
So where's the mystery if we already know who did it?
Well, it's the first trial that we're getting, so it's like going to be pretty easy, I'm assuming.
Am I still the
judge? Hey, I see.
Am I still the judge?
Yeah.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Larry Butts.
I just spit out everywhere. Oh my god.
Yeah, but what's the point? I don't get it. But maybe it's because it's the first trial. You're him.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. The, defense is ready, Your Honor.
Mr. Wright, this is your first trial, is it not?
Yes, Your Honor. I'm a little nervous.
Your conduct during this trial will decide the fate of your client. Murder is a serious charge. For your client's sake, I hope you can control your nerves.
Thank you, Your Honor?
That was not a compliment. Why do you make him sound super old? I mean, look at him. He is super old.
Yeah, have you not looked at him?
Mr. Wright, given the circumstances, I think we should have a test to ascertain your readiness.
Yes, Your Honor. Ugh. Hand shaking, eyesight fading.
It does look pretty fucking old.
The test will consist of a few simple questions. Answer them clearly and concisely. Please state the name of the defendant in this case.
The defendant? Well, that's Larry Butts, Your Honor.
Correct. Just keep your wits about you and you'll do fine. Next question. This is a murder trial. Tell me, what's the victim's name? Have we learned that?
Yeah, have we learned that?
Have we learned that?
I know this one. Glad I read the case report cover to cover so many times. It's... Wait. Uh-oh. No. No way! I forgot! I'm drawing a total blank here.
Oh my god! Phoenix, are you absolutely sure you're up for this? You don't even know the victim's name?
Oh, the victim! Of course I know the victim's name! I just forgot. Temporarily.
Yeah.
Look, the victim's name is listed in the court record.
Ooh, Arby.
Hmm?
No. Oh, Cindy.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Cause of death, loss of blood due to blunt trauma.
Just press the right bumper.
I already did it, motherfucker.
Okay.
Why am I hearing cars?
I don't know, but I'm hearing it too.
Let me fucking close my window, I fucking guess.
Okay.
Damn, people pissing me off. Okay, anyways.
Remember to check it often. Do it for me, please. I am begging you.
Mr. Wright, who is the victim in this case?
Hey, wait.
It's Cindy. It's not Cinder.
Yeah, but what's the last name?
The only one that says Cindy. Cindy Stone. That is Cinder.
There's two!
That's Cinder!
The victim's name is Cindy Stone.
Correct.
I mean, it's close enough. Cinderblock.
No.
Now tell me, what was the cause of death? She died because she was...
She was struck once by a blunt object.
Correct. You've answered all of my questions. I see no reason why we shouldn't proceed. You seem much more relaxed, Mr. Wright. Good for you.
Thank you, Your Honor. Because I don't feel relaxed, that's for sure.
I love the little, like, emotions.
Well then.
Yeah.
First, a question for the prosecution. Mr. Payne?
Yes, Your Honor?
As Mr. Wright just told us, the victim was struck with a blunt object. Would you explain to the court just what that object was?
The murder weapon was the statue of the Thinker. Was found lying on the floor next to the victim.
I see. The court accepts it into evidence.
Statue of the shape of the Thinker. It's rather heavy.
Yeah, it would seem so. Right.
Be sure to pay attention to any evidence added during the trial. That evidence is the only ammunition you have in court. Use the right bumper to check the court record frequently.
Bonk.
Mr. Payne, the prosecution may call its first witness.
The prosecution calls the defendant, Mr. Butts, to the stand.
Wait, nope. I thought that was me.
Chief, what do I do now?
Pay attention. You don't want to miss any information that might help your client's case. You'll get your chance to respond to the prosecution later, so be ready. Let's just hope he doesn't say anything unfortunate.
Uh-oh, Larry gets excited easily. This could be bad.
Oh God.
Did his eye twitch?
Maybe he did kill her.
Mr. Butts, is it not true that the victim had recently dumped you?
Hey, watch it, buddy.
Silly.
We were great together. We were Romeo and Juliet, Cleopatra and Mark Anthony.
Didn't they all die?
I was dumped. She just wasn't taking my phone calls or seeing me ever.
God, this guy drank a fucking Monster Energy drink before coming here, I
His
swear.
eyes are twitching.
Look at that eye twitch.
That and his
Yeah.
little. Oh God. What's it to you anyway?
Mr. Butts, what you describe is generally what we mean by dumped. In fact, she had completely abandoned you and was seeing other men. She had just returned from overseas with one of them the day before the murder.
What do you mean, one of them? Lies! All of it lies! I don't believe a word of it!
Your Honor, the victim's passport. According to this, she was in Paris until the day before she died. The victim apparently arrived home from Paris on 7:30, the day before the murder.
Indeed, she appears to have returned the day before the murder. Dude, no way.
The victim was a model, but did not have a large income. It appears that she had several sugar daddies.
Sugar daddies. Daddies? Sugar?
Yes, older men who gave her money in gifts. She took their money and used it to support her lifestyle.
Dude.
We could clearly see what kind of woman this Miss Stone was. Tell me, Mr. Butts, what do you think of her now? That's not. You can't ask a question like that. I'm pretty fucking sure you can't ask a question like that in court. What is that, like hearsay or something? Yeah, Larry has a way of running his mouth in all the wrong directions. Should I? My client had no idea the victim was seeing other men. That question is irrelevant to this case. Oof. Ugh.
Dude, Nick, what do you mean irrelevant? That cheating she dog. Oh God. I'm gonna die. I'm just gonna drop dead. Abduction. Oh, I'm gonna get to the bottom of this when I get me see her in the afterlife. Let's continue with the trial, shall we?
I believe the accused's motives is clear to everyone.
Yes, quite.
Oh boy, this is so not looking good. Next question. You went to the victim's apartment on the day of the murder, did you not?
Gulp.
God. Well, did you or did you not?
Well, maybe I did, maybe I didn't. What the fuck are you on about?
Hey, you swore to tell the truth and nothing but the truth when you got
Yeah.
up on that stand. I know how the courts work in a very basic sense. Uh-oh, he went. What do I do?
Probably have him answer honestly.
Yeah. I know. I'll send him a signal. Tell the truth.
Yeah, I was there. I win. Order. Well, Mr. Butts. Dude, chill. She wasn't home, man.
seer.
Whoa.
What the fuck was that? Objection! Your honor, the defendant is lying.
Oh shit. He's like, it's like he's never heard of that concept before. People can lie? I thought when they came here, they could not lie. That was just impossible. They promised!
He swore to tell the truth and nothing but the truth.
Yay, Pinky promised.
Lying?
The prosecution would like to call a witness who can prove Mr. Butts is lying.
Well, that simplifies matters. Who is your witness?
Ooh, it's the murderer.
The man who found the victim's body just before making the gruesome discovery. He saw the defendant fleeing the scene of the crime.
Order! Order in the court! Mr. Payne, the prosecution may call it to witness.
Yes, Your Honor. Oh, this is bad. On the day of the murder, my witness was selling newspapers at the victim's building. Please bring Frank Sawit.
Yeah.
Please bring Frank Sawit to the stand.
Ew, he's so ugly.
Oh, why does he look like that? Mr. Sawit, you sell newspaper subscriptions, is this correct? Oh god, that's me too, isn't it?
Yeah, you can be Sawit.
Oh, yes. Newspapers, yes.
Mr. Sawit, you may proceed with your testimony. Please tell the court what you saw on the day of the murder.
Witness testimony. I was going door to door selling subscriptions when I saw a man fleeing an apartment. I saw he must be in a hurry because he left that door half open behind him. Thinking it strange, I looked inside the apartment. Then I saw her lying there, a woman, not moving, dead. I quailed in fright and found myself unable to go inside. I thought to call the police immediately. However, the phone in her apartment wasn't working. I went to a nearby park and found a public phone. I remember the time exactly. It was 1 o'clock p.m. The man who ran was, without a doubt, the defendant sitting right over there. Larry, why didn't you tell the truth? I can't defend you against a testimony like that.
Well, he probably did tell the truth.
Incidentally, why wasn't the phone in the victim's apartment working?
Your Honor, at the time of the murder, there was a blackout in the building.
Aren't phones supposed to work during a blackout?
Yes, Your Honor. However, some cordless phones do not function normally. The phone that Mr. Sawit used was one of those. Your Honor, I have a record of the blackout for your per usual. Ooh, electricity to Miss Stone's building was out from noon to 6 p.m. on the day of the crime. Ooh.
Now, Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor?
You may begin your cross-examination.
Cross-examination, Your Honor?
Alright, this is it. The real deal.
What exactly am I supposed to do?
Why, you exposed the lies in the testimony the witness just gave.
Lies? What? He was lying?
Your client is innocent, right? Then that witness must have lied in his testimony. Or is your client really guilty?
How do I prove he's not?
You hold the key. It's in the evidence. Compare the witness's testimony to the evidence at hand. There's bound to be a contradiction in there. First, find contradictions between the court report and the witness's testimony. Then, once you've found the contradicting evidence, present it and rub it in the witness's face.
Okay.
Open the court record with the right bumper, then point out contradictions in the testimony.
Alright. Hold on. So, the cause of death is at 7:31, or
time
whatever, what is that, 4 fucking...
4 p.m. to 5 p.m., which already doesn't make sense because it says...
And... Okay.
Hang on, I've already found an inconsistency. He said it was exactly 3 p.m. It says there that she must have died at 4 p.m.
Oh, yeah, no, it wasn't even 3, it was 1.
Yeah.
He said it was 1,
so there's
yeah.
1.
Yes, so. Present this, right?
Present the evidence, then shoot the witness in the face. Yeah, it would be her. Yeah.
Objection!
Sorry, I was spamming A, and I realized A wasn't the button I was supposed to be pressing, it was Y. Oh. You found the body at 1 o'clock p.m., you're sure? Yes, it was 1 o'clock p.m. for certain. Frankly, I find that hard to believe. Your statement directly contradicts the autopsy report. The autopsy notes that the time of death was sometime after 4 p.m. There was nobody to, nobody to find at 1 o'clock p.m. How do you explain this 3-hour gap?
Nice job.
Objection! This is trivial! The witness merely forgot the time!
After his testimony, I find that hard to believe. Mr. Sawit? Why were you so certain you found the body at 1 p.m.?
That's a really good question.
Great job, right? Way to put him on the spot. Literally. That's all you have to do. Point out contradictions. Lies always beget more lies. See through one, and their whole story falls apart. Hell yeah!
Wait! I remember now!
Would you care to give your testimony again? Yeah, this
oh, God.
Wow, I should be a lawyer.
You see, when I found the body, I heard the time. There was a voice saying the time. It's probably coming from the television. No, oh my God. There was a blackout.
Yeah, what?
There was a fucking blackout. What are you? Let me present. Oh, but it was 3 hours off, wasn't it? I guess the victim must have been watching a video taped of a taped program. That's why I thought it was 1 o'clock p.m. Terribly sorry about the misunderstanding.
I see. You had a voice saying that tape on a taped program. Tape? Time. Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness. Okay. Right! Okay, yeah, we get it. You know what to do.
I got this one.
You do, because why
yeah,
has nobody
I fucking
else
do.
Why has nobody else pointed this out?
Yeah, exactly.
Present.
So it'd be this one.
It'd be the yeah.
Hold it right there! The prosecution has said there was a blackout at the time of the discovery. And this record proves it. Ding! You couldn't have heard the television or a video. Yeah!
The defense has a point. Do you have an explanation for this, Mr. Sawit?
No, I find it quite puzzling myself, quite. Wait, I remember now.
Mr. Sowit?
Oh my god.
The court would prefer to hear an accurate testimony from the very beginning. His constant corrections are harming your credibility. That, and you seem rather distraught.
My apologies, Your Honor.
Oh, shit.
Must have been the shock of finding the body.
Okay, it's fine now. It was glitching for a second.
Very well, oh, God. Mr. Solid. Let's hear your testimony once more, please. What in the world? Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm gonna kill this man. Actually, I didn't hear the time. I saw it. There's a tail clock in the apartment. It wasn't there. Yeah, the murder weapon. The killer used it to hit the... My god.
I know this is, like, the first level, so it's supposed to be really easy, but what the fuck?
I want to bash this man's head in with the murder weapon.
Yeah.
That must have been what I saw.
You saw a clock? I guess I would explain.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's fine. The defense may cross-examine the witness. The guy's obviously a moron, yeah.
Gladly. God.
Fuck him up. Fuck him up. Right here. Press on.
Objection!
Wait! Wait just a moment! The murder weapon wasn't a clock. It was the statue. Now, how is this supposed to be a clock? What? You with your objections and your evidence? Just who do you think you are? Just answer the question, Mr. Sawit. Hey, I saw it there, okay? That's a clock. Your Honor, if I may.
Yes, Mr. Payne.
As the witness stated, this statue is indeed a clock.
What?
His neck is a switch. You just tilt it, and it says the time out loud. As it doesn't look like a clock, I submitted it as a statue. My apologies.
I see. So the murder... What? So the murder weapon was a table clock after all. Well, Mr. Wright? Appears that the witness's testimony is correct. This is a clock.
Nope. Do we want to say yes?
You're just gonna believe that it's a clock right away? Is there a way to check it?
Well, it completely depends on if it is even battery operated or not. Because if it's not, then the blackout would have rendered it fucking useless. I want to say yes. Your Honor, there's a gaping hole in the witness's testimony. The only way he could have known the weapon was a clock is to hold it in his hand.
Oh.
Yet, and the witness testified he never entered the apartment.
Ooh, nice.
I didn't even know that. I'm glad I said yes. Clearly, a contradiction.
Hmm, indeed.
The witness knew it was a clock because he...
Probably went into the apartment, since he's the one who killed her.
You're lying! You were inside the apartment on the day of the murder. Oh yeah? Prove it! Prove I went in there! I'll do better than that. I can prove you were the one who killed her! You struck her with the clock and the... shock of the blow triggered the clock's voice. That was the sound you heard.
How do we know this?
Order in the court. Intriguing. Please continue, Mr. Wright.
I'm having, like, flashbacks to Danganronpa.
Me too, and I keep not wanting to say it because that's so embarrassing to say, but I keep thinking...
Well, I said it for you, so don't worry.
Thank you.
Yes, Your Honor. Mr. Sawit, this town must have left quite an impression on you. Understandable, since the murder weapon spoke just as you hit the victim. That voice was burned into your mind. That's why you were so certain about the time.
Objection!
What's the meaning of this? This is all baseless conjecture. Baseless? Just look at the witness's face.
Would the witness care to elaborate? Did you strike the victim with the clock?
That day, I never! Look, I swear, the clock, I heard, no, I mean,
what?
Oh my god. Shut up, I hate you. It was him, I tell you, I saw him. He killed her, and he should burn, give him death.
Order in the court, I say.
It's the fact that he threw his wig.
I don't think that
Phoenix right. Your Honor, a moment, please. There isn't a shred of evidence supporting the defense's claims.
Mr. Wright.
Your Honor?
You claim the sound the witness heard came from the clock.
As everyone else said?
Yeah.
Do you have any evidence?
Case is writing on this. I better think it through carefully. Your Honor, sound Mrs. Stalwart heard was definitely this clock. A fact which is clear if you simply... We're not even sure if the neighbors are there. No, we have not said a single thing about the neighbors, so that is off the menu.
I'm so scared, but I don't see what examining the clock's batteries would do. How would that prove that they made the noise?
Mm-hmm. Well, we're still at full health, so... Let's stop the clock now, here in this court, Your Honor. May I have the clock? I ask the court to listen very carefully. I think it's 8:25.
I think.
That's certainly a strange
Well, that's because it's called The Thinker.
Oh, yeah.
So it's going like, I think.
That's cute.
That certainly is a strange way to announce the time.
Well, he is The Thinker, after all. Yep.
Yep.
So, we've heard the clock. What are your conclusions, Mr. Wright?
What kind of fucking clock does someone have where you can only check the time by, like, bunking it?
What kind of court even is this?
Mr. Payne, can you tell me what time it is right now? It's 11:25. That! As you can see, this clock is exactly 3 hours slow. Precisely the discrepancy between what Mr. Sawit heard and the actual death. So, Mr. Sawit, try to talk your way out of this one. Ha! You forgot one thing! Uh-oh, what's he talking about now? Well, it may seem like the clock is running 3 hours slow. It proves nothing! How do you know it was running 3 hours slow on the day of the murder? If you can't prove that, you don't have a case.
What?
He's right. How
no.
am I going to prove that?
I'm pretty sure this is enough proof.
Damn it. I was so close.
Mr. Wright.
Oh, that's not me.
Ew. Seems you lack the critical courage to support your claim. No, we're not going to shoot him.
Yes, Your Honor. I see.
Sorry, what the fuck do you mean?
This means I cannot let you indict the witness. Unfortunately.
What? Did we fuck it up?
We have to switch, we're probably switching back to to Larry Butts, maybe? I come all the way down here to testify, and look what happens. You treat me like a criminal. A criminal! You lawyers are all slime. Grr. I almost had him. Sorry, Larry. I failed you. There's nothing I can do about it now.
Not so fast, Mr. Sawit.
Mia, I mean, Chief!
Listen up, Wright. Don't throw this one away. Not like this. Think.
But, Chief, it's over. I can't prove the clock was slow the day of the murder. Nobody can prove that.
Well, yes. But that doesn't mean you can't still win. Try thinking out of the box. Don't waste time doubting the facts. Assume the clock was 3 hours slow and think through it. Ask yourself.
We still haven't.
Why?
We still haven't figured, or like, we have the passport. I'm sorry. We have the passport, but we haven't used that as evidence yet.
Maybe
they give us red herrings.
I mean, no, it could also be because she was in Paris. Is that... Maybe that's 3 hours behind. Mm-hmm. It wouldn't make a lot of sense.
Yeah.
But maybe. Anyways, I read
mm-hmm.
it. Figure out the reason and you'll have your proof. Right? Right? Can you think of a reason as to why the clock would be 3 hours slow? Yes.
I'm gonna say yes anyways because
yeah.
He knows. He knows what I don't know. Wait! Maybe I can prove it.
You must have evidence somewhere that can prove it, right? Find it and let them have it. Well, Mr. Wright, you say the clock was already running slow on the day of the murder. Have you found evidence to support this claim?
Of course. There's a piece of evidence on the court record that can prove my claim beyond a doubt. Ha! Tough words! Let's see you try to pull this one off.
Let's see this evidence that proves why the clock was running slow.
Yeah, the only one you haven't used was the passport.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we can try it.
Okay, but... why?
I don't know. Maybe she wanted to get used to the time over there.
You're right. Well, we don't know where we are now.
Yeah, again, it doesn't make much sense because why would you do that? But still, it's like the closest. It would have something to do with the time zone.
Take that! The victim had just returned home abroad the day before the murder. As we all know, the time difference between here and Paris is 9 hours. When it's 4 o'clock there, it's 1 a.m. the next day here. The clock wasn't 3 hours slow, it was 3 hours fast. Nine hours fast. Shut up.
No, sorry.
The victim hadn't reset her clock since returning home. That's why the time you heard when you struck her dead in her apartment was wrong. Proof enough for you, Mr. Sawit? Or should I say, Mr. Did It?
Oh, Mr. Saw It? Like, he saw it? Ew.
Oh my god.
Order, I say.
Oh, shit. Well, you took cyanide.
Well, this case has certainly turned out differently than we all expected, not me. Mr. Payne, you're a witness.
He was arrested and has been taken away, Your Honor.
Oh, shit.
Very well. Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
I have to say, I'm in.
I have to say. Oh, nope, that's not me.
I said it.
I don't think I've ever seen someone complete a defense so quickly.
It's because it was so easy.
And find the true culprits at the same time.
Thank you, Your Honor.
At this point, this is only formality, but... this court finds the defendant, Mr. Larry Butts, not guilty.
Is this what they Yippee. Do at actually court? Like, at courts, do they just have confetti?
They pop some confetti.
Yeah.
Yeah. With that, this court is adjourned. Easy to have.
Turns out that Frank saw it was a common burglar. He posed as a newspaper salesman to check and see when people were out of the house that day. When Larry went to her apartment, the victim wasn't home. After he left, Mr. Sawit let himself in to do his dirty work. While he was searching her place, the victim returned. Flustered, Mr. Sawit grabbed the nearest blunt object he could find. That's sad. Phew, I still can't believe we won.
Right, good job. Aww. There. Congratulations.
Thanks, Chief. I owe it all to you.
Not at all, not at all. You fought your own battles in there.
It's been a oh my goodness.
It's been a while since I've seen a girl end on such a satisfying note.
I've never seen the Chief looking this happy. She's this glad. Imagine how Larry must feel.
My life is over.
Oh, look at it.
I mean, his girlfriend did. Die.
Yeah, well, his girlfriend was also cheating on him, so.
Yeah.
Larry, you're supposed to be happy. What's wrong now?
Yeah. Aw, Nick. Don't worry about me. I'll be dead and gone soon. What?
Good. Wait, no, I mean bad. Bad, bad, bad!
I like this.
Larry, you're innocent. The case is closed.
But my Sydney Wendy's gone, man. Gone forever.
Larry, she was a whore.
My Sydney Wendy. Larry, she was a whore. She was a slut.
Ooh, she's so pretty. Oh, he's immediately gonna be happy because a pretty woman smiled at him.
Congratulations, Harry.
Oh, that's not his name. Harry?
Yes, you. I can practically see the headlines now. Harry Butts, innocent.
Oh my god.
thanks! I really owe you one. I told you. I won't forget this. Ever! Let's celebrate! Dinner? Movie? My treat!
Oh no, I couldn't.
Hey, I was the one who got you off the hook.
Hi.
Oh, hey! Here, take this! It's a present!
The murder weapon?
Oh my god.
A present? For me?
This is horrible!
Wait, wasn't this the evidence that... Actually, I made this clock for her.
Well, that explains why it was so fucking weird.
Yeah, I made one for her and one for me! You made this? Well, thank you. I'll keep it as a memento.
It has blood on it. Or it had blood on it. Yo, Nick.
Can you believe it? I was so into that chick. And she was just playing for me for a fool!
He finally got over her.
Yeah. Don't that make you just wanna cry?
Larry.
Are you so sure? Excuse me? I love saying that.
I love saying that!
Me too!
Yeah!
I think she thought quite a lot of you, in her own way. Nah, you don't gotta sympathize with me, it's okay. Oh, I'm not just sympathizing, really. Isn't that right, right? Don't you have something to show for your friend? Something that proves how she felt about him?
What the heck is she talking about? Should I give him the statue back? With blood on it?
I don't know what it means.
Take that! Check this out, Larry. Proof positive you weren't just some chump to her.
Huh? What about that clock?
This is the clock you made for her, Larry. She took it with her when she traveled.
Whatever, she probably just needed a clock, that's all.
You think so? It's a pretty heavy clock to take traveling. I'll make of it what you will.
Hey, Nick. I'm glad I asked you to be my lawyer. Really, I am. Thanks.
Hope that made him feel a little better.
Right. I hope you see the importance of evidence now. Also, hopefully you realize, things change depending on how you look at them. People too.
What do you mean by this? 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 What do you mean?
We really never know if our clients are guilty or innocent unless you're us, in case we do.
Fuck, you're telling me I'm gonna have guilty people?
Shit. I think so. I mean, that's
but if I'm defending them, then that means I'm gonna need to, like, prove that they're not guilty, even if they are guilty. What the fuck?
Yeah.
God. Damn.
All we can do is believe in them. And in order to believe in them, you have to believe in yourself. Right. Listen, learn. Grow strong. What the fuck? She sounds like a kindergarten teacher. Never let go of what you believe in. Never. Well, I think our work here is done. Shall we be off?
Yeah, I guess so.
Say, how about dinner? On me. We'll drink a toast to innocent butts.
Yeah!
Oh, speaking of Harry. You were saying part of why you became a lawyer was because of him.
Yeah, well, part, at least.
You'll have to tell me more about it sometime. Maybe over drinks.
And so my first trial came to a close. Larry slapped me on the back and said, "Gee, Nick! That's good to have friends."
Gee, Nick.
But I'm pretty Gee, Nick. But I'm pretty sure he's not going to pay us, unless you count the clock he gave Mia.
Oh my god.
I didn't know it then, but that clock was soon going to be at the center of another incident. My promise to tell the chief about me and Larry would be one promise I wouldn't be able to keep. What?
Is
what?
She gonna die?
What? 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 No.
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 God damn it. God damn it. Episode 2.
Okay, hang
on.
Oh
my god.
Hang on. I want to go get a soda. Okay, I just said hang on.
Well.
I will be right back.
Get your
okay?
soda.
I will. By the way, is Brad back yet? Has he updated you?
He hasn't texted me.
Okay, and then he's probably still busy. I will be right back.
Say, Vivid Cult, how do you like this at all? I don't remember if you said that you liked this game or, like, knew anything about it.
Okay, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Thank you. Turnabout Sisters.
Dear God. Bring. Beep.
Who's Maya?
Ooh, do you want to be Maya? Or do you want me to be Maya?
I don't care.
Let me bring out my inner girl voice.
Okay.
I have to sit up for this one.
Okay.
Hello? This is Maya.
Hey Maya, it's me.
Ooh. I'm glad I was Maya.
Yeah.
Mia! What's up? You haven't called in a while.
Are they sisters? Sorry, I've been so busy.
Oh. Well, lonely. That's all your fault. Nah, I'm just teasing. Been great. I'm finally getting used to having my own place.
That's good to hear. Actually, I'm calling because I have a favor to ask.
I know. You want me to hold evidence for you?
Sharp as always. There's a lot of buzz about the upcoming trial. I just don't feel safe keeping the evidence here.
Hi, gotcha. So, what is it this time?
It's a clock.
Oh my god. A clock?
Yes, it's made to look like that statue, the Thinker. And it tells you the time. I thought you might like it. You always like toys.
Don't say that.
Stop.
Hey, I'm not a little girl anymore, sis.
Now, you know I'm only teasing. I should probably tell you.
Fucking nice.
That's what I have to tell you.
Huh? It's not working? That's lame.
I had to take the clockwork out. Sorry. I put some papers inside it instead.
Papers? Is that the evidence then? Well, it's a possibility it might turn out that way, yes.
What? That was a random person. Wait, never mind. Huh? Never mind. Can you come by the office tonight, say 9 o'clock, to pick it up? I'll be in a pre-trial meeting until then.
Okay, sis. I expect dinner. Something good. Like burgers, really go for a good burger. That's a girl speaking from my heart. Mm-hmm. I love her. Love her already. Don't know who she is.
She's
but she likes burgers.
Maya.
I know, but I don't know her.
Okay, well, she's Maya. That's all you need to know.
Fuck you.
Okay, we'll hit the usual joints.
All right, it's a deal. Okay, sis. I'll see you soon.
Yeah, I'll be waiting, Maya. Wait, I don't want Mia.
Ooh, don't like that beep.
I don't want Mia to die. I like voicing her.
Conversation recorded September 5th. Oh, God.
She's gonna die.
September 5th, 9:27 a.m. Oh, God. Oh, God.
This is our culprit. Am I the culprit?
I was the culprit last time. Yeah, okay. I was the culprit last time. You beat this one.
Now, Miss Faye, I'll take what's mine. The papers.
I'm sorry, but I can't give you what I don't have.
Miss Faye, you are a poor liar. Why, I see it right over there. That must be the thinker that swallowed those papers.
How could you know?
Oh, you are not cogniferous of my background? Gathering information is my business, you see.
I can't wait to see this guy's face to know what voice this belongs to.
Should have been more careful.
My dear Miss Faye, I am so very sorry. But I am afraid I must ask you for one more thing. Your eternal silence. Farewell, Miss Faye.
Hey, no. Hey. Not again.
Hey, I thought that statue was... Oh my
okay.
God! It's the face!
Red, white, blue?
Oh my God!
You know what? The voice kind of fits.
The
voice kind of fits.
Oh no. Uh-oh, I'm late. Huh, that's strange. Guess the chief left without me. She said her sister was coming over, so we should all hang out for dinner. What's that smell? Blood?
Blood?
Mia! Maybe she's in her office.
Probably move.
I'd hate to say, but Brad just texted me.
Saying he's back?
And said he's on. Hey!
He's in chat.
Hey, Brad. He's in chat. Yeah. I don't think I want to see Mia's dead body anyways.
But I can watch if need be. No, we can switch over to Monster Palm.
No, we just started this, so this is like the beginning of the second episode. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. That voice was fucking perfect.
Mrs. Faye.
No, you don't need to download. So basically how the game works is I screen share it and you just tell me where you go. It's a dating sim that's multiplayer. So. And it's gonna be a lot of voicing. So. You wanna exit out? I'm gonna end the stream so I
let
can...
Let me save.
Okay.
I'm gonna add him to the...
Yeah, I'm gonna end
How
the
do...
stream, and then we're gonna
How
play
I...
Monster Prom, so if anybody wants to join back when we start again, feel free.